வெல்கம் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ். இந்த லாஸ்ட் லெக்சர் வி ஹவ் லேர்ன் த எஃபிஷியன்சி ஆஃப் ரீஹீட் சைக்கிள், த ஹீட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சர் சைக்கிள் அண்ட் ரீஹீட் அண்ட் ரீஹீட் ஹீட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சர் சைக்கிள் ரீஹீட் அண்ட் ஹீட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சர் சைக்கிள். ஸோ இன் திஸ் லெக்சர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் த எஃபிஷியன்சி, ஹவு டு டிரைவ் த எஃபிஷியன்சி ஆஃப் இன்டர்கூலர் சைக்கிள் and reheat heat exchanger and intercooler, combination of these three arrangement, and also we will going to differentiate the cycle efficiency and specific work output for all of these cases. Okay, and we will do some numerical on the different cycle, on the different cycle. Now the intercooler cycle, the another way of increasing the specific work output of gas turbine is reducing the work of compression that is the compression in more than one stage and using intercooler between the compressor. So let's see what is the working principle of the intercooler cycle. This one is the compressor 1, this one is the compressor 2, this is the turbine combustion chamber and this is the intercooler. Okay, so in the first turbine, air is sucked in the first turbine, then it's being compressed, that is 1 to 2 process, the adiabatic compression process. In this PV diagram you can see this is the 1 to 2 process, adiabatic compression process. Then the air, the compressed air, the heated compressed air, the heat is increased, that is 1 to 2 in the TS diagram. Then this air is flows to the intercooler, and in this intercooler its temperature is getting reduced. Okay, its temperature is getting reduced in constant pressure process. This is a constant pressure process 2 to 3. That is the intercooler process 2 to 3, the constant pressure process, but the temperature is getting reduced. Then again the air enters to the compressor 2, that is 3 to 4, then the air being compressed adiabatically, that is 3 to 4, this process, the temperature is again increased 3 to 4, then the air goes to the combustion chamber, the fuel is added, combustion takes place, and then the combustion product flows through the turbine adiabatically, that is 5 to 6. This is the 5 to 6 process. This is the 5 to 6, the constant entropy process, and 6 to 1 is the exhaust. Okay. So this is the basic working principle of intercooled cycle. So let's see the different work, that is first one is the compression work, that is this one is the compressor 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, so W1 to 2 plus W3 to 4, so nothing but Cp into T2 minus T1 plus Cp into T4 minus T3. The heat addition, that is combustion chamber, that is 4 to 5, that is Q4 5, that is H5 minus H4, that is equals to Cp T5 minus T4, and the turbine work, that is H5 minus H6. This is the turbine work, H5 minus H 5 to 6. So Cp T5 minus T6. Okay, these are the work, the compression work, the heat addition work, and the turbine work. Now the net work output, that is Wn, is equals to Cp into T1. Again, I am telling you, the net work output is nothing but the turbine work minus the compression, the compressor work. The turbine work minus the compressor work. So that is by taking common, that is that Cp into T1, we are going to take common this. So that becomes T5 by T1 minus T6 by T1 minus T2 by T1 plus T3 by T1 minus T4 by T1 plus 1. Okay, so this is the net work output. So now we are going to assume that is T5 by T1. This is the maximum temperature by the minimum temperature. The maximum and minimum temperature ratio is T, and T5 by T6 is equals to C. You know, C equals to nothing but R to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, and C2 by C1 is equals to T2 by T1 is equals to C1, and T4 by T3 is equals to C2. So the T3 is equals to T2. Okay, so from this the above relation we can say that T3 equals to So from the above relation we can say that the T3 equals to T1. Okay, from the above relation we can say that T3 equals to T1, and for maximum specific work output, we can say C1 is equals to root C is equals to C2. C1 equals to root C equals to C2. Then the maximum work output becomes W max by Cp into T1. So that is T minus T by C minus 2 into root over C plus 2. Okay. So the maximum efficiency of this interpool cycle is that is 1 minus T by C plus root over C minus 2 by T minus root C. So because of the lower compressor outlet temperature, the fuel flow rate is to obtained given turbine inlet temperature will increase. Therefore, the thermal efficiency of the intercooled cycle will less than that of the simple gas turbine cycle. Okay. Now the intercooled cycle with heat exchange and reheat. Intercooled cycle with heat exchanger and reheat. Okay. So let's see the working principle. This is a low pressure compressor. This is a high pressure compressor. This is an intercooler. This is a high pressure turbine. This one is the first one is the high pressure turbine. Second one is the low pressure turbine. Okay, and this is the high pressure turbine. This is the low pressure turbine. This is the combustion chamber, and this one is the combustion chamber, reheat combustion chamber. This is the heat exchanger, and this one is the intercooler. Okay. So let's see the working principle of this intercooled heat exchanger with reheat. First, the air is getting sucked by this low pressure compressor. Okay, that is 1-2, the adiabatic compression process 1-2. Then it flows through the intercooler and it is getting cooled. This is the 1-2, that is then 2-3 is the intercooler process. 2-3. The temperature is being decreased. Okay, 2-3 is the constant pressure process. Then 3-4, it's again compressed through the high pressure turbine. That is 3-4. Okay, this is the adiabatic compression process where the entropy is being constant. The 3-4 process, 3-4 adiabatic compression process, and after it's being compressed by the high pressure turbine, then it flows through the heat exchanger. This is a heat exchanger. So in this heat exchanger, it's gain heat from the flue gas. It's gain heat from the flue gas. Okay, then the heated air, that one thing, 4-9 is the heat exchanger process. This is the 4-9 constant pressure process. 4-9 is getting heated from the, it's taking heat from the heat exchanger. Then 9-5 is the combustion chamber, that is the combustion process. 9-5, this is the 9-5 process, the combustion chamber process. First combustion chamber, it's mixed with the fuel and then combustion takes place in the combustion process. Then 5-6 is the high pressure turbine. Then it flows through the high pressure turbine, the combustion product, that is 5-6. This is 5, this is 6, the adiabatic expansion process. This is 5 and this point is 6, flows through the high pressure turbine 5 to 6, the constant entropy process, the adiabatic process. Then after flowing through the turbine, high pressure turbine, it's again reheated in the reheat combustion chamber. This is the reheat combustion chamber 6 to 7. It's being heated 6 to 7, constant pressure process. Then again it flows through the low pressure turbine, that is 7 to 8. This is 7 to 8 is the low pressure turbine process, is the adiabatic process, 7 to 8. Okay, then after by flowing through the low pressure turbine, the outlet product, outlet flue gas, it flows through the turbine, that is 8 to 10. This is 8 to 10, so it exchanges its heat with the compressed air and it uses the temperature, and the compressed air getting heated or gain the temperature, that is 8 to 10. This point is 8, this point is 10, 8 to 10. Okay, is a heat exchanger process, and 10 to 1 is the exhaust. Okay, so this is the intercooled cycle with heat exchanger and reheat. So let's see the compressor what. So there is two compressors present, so that is W1 to 2, first compressor, high pressure, and W3 to 4 is the second compressor. So that is the Cp into T2 minus T1 plus Cp into T1 T4 minus T3. Heat addition process is Q9 to 5 and Q6 to 7, that is Cp into T5 minus T9 plus Cp into T7 minus T8. And the turbine work, that is W7 to 8 plus W5 to 6. So Cp into T7 minus T8 plus Cp into T5 minus T6. Okay. So these are the turbine work, because there are two turbines present and two combustion chamber is also there. So the maximum specific work output is nothing but the maximum work, that means the turbine work, this is the turbine work minus the compressor work, is the maximum work by Cp into T1. So that becomes 2 into T minus T by root C minus root C plus 1. Here we are assuming that T6 equals to T8. This 6 and 8 is same. Okay, we are assuming that. So the maximum efficiency becomes 1 minus root C by T. So the maximum efficiency for this combined cycle is 1 minus root C by T. So this is the chart, this is the comparison of various cycles for R equals to 4 and T equals to 3. R equals to 4 and T equals to 3. Okay, we are assuming. So in this various comparison, you can see the last one, that is reheat, intercooling and heat exchange. In case of last one, this is very important. The efficiency becomes 80% and the maximum work output, that is, becomes 34.7%. So this is the, so this process is very much effective. Okay, so that's why the max in the maximum industry follows this process. Okay, because this is very much effective, other than the different process. This one is very much effective, and you can see in the intercooler process, only intercooling is there. This process, the efficiency is getting hugely decreased here, that is minus 6.5%. The specific work output is 10.2%. Okay, so let's do a simple numerical. It says that compute the indicated mean effective pressure and efficiency of a Joule cycle if the temperature at the end of combustion is 2000 Kelvin and the temperature and pressure before the compression is 350 Kelvin and 1 bar, the pressure ratio is 1.3. Assume Cp equals to 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So since it's a simple Breton cycle problem, the PV diagram is shown here. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 to 2 is the adiabatic compression process. 2 to 3 is the combustion process, constant pressure combustion process. 3 to 4 is the adiabatic expansion process through turbine, and 4 to 1 is the exhaust, constant pressure. So let's consider, we are considering that that I have telling you that the T1 is equals to the T2 is equals to, for the isentropic compression process, that is 1 to 2, T2 is equals to T1 into P2 by P1, and T1 is the inlet temperature, P2 by P1 is the pressure ratio. P2 by P1 is the pressure ratio. So by substituting all these values, and gamma equals to 1.4, we are assuming that gamma for air, that is 1.4. This is the gamma, this is gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is gamma minus 1 by gamma. Gamma is 1.4. So by substituting all these values, we get T2 equals to 377.27 Kelvin. Now again, considering the process 3 to 4, this is also the adiabatic process, 3 to 4, or isentropic process, reversible adiabatic process or isentropic process. So T4 becomes T3 into T4 by P4 by P3. T4 is equals to T3 into P4 by P3. Here P3 and P2 is same, and P4 and P1 is same. So P4 by P3 is becomes 1 by the 1 by pressure ratio, that is 1 by 1.3. And T3 is the 2000 Kelvin. It's given here. That is at the end of combustion is 2000 Kelvin, the maximum temperature. So the T4 becomes 1855.24 Kelvin. Okay. Now the work done in the compression process, that is the WC, that is Cp into T2 minus T1. So that is 27.40 kilojoule per kg. And the work done in turbine process, that is Cp into T3 minus T4, that is 145.30 kilojoule per kg. So the net work done, that is Wn, that is Wt minus Wc, that is 117.90 kilojoule per kg. Now the various state points, the volume at various state points. First one, the V1, that is we can write V1 is equals to RT1 by P1. So R value is 0.287 into 10 to the power 3 joule per kg Kelvin into 350 by 1 into 10 to the power 5, because P1 is the 1 bar into 10 to the power 5. So that becomes 1.0045 meter cube per kg. Similarly, the V2 is R into T2 by P3, R into T2 by P3, and V3 is R into T3 by P3, and V4 is R into T4 by P4. So the V2 is value is this, that is 0.833 meter cube per kg. V3 is 4.415 meter cube per kg, and V4 5.325 meter cube per kg. Okay, so the indicated mean effective pressure is net work done by the change in volume. So the net work done, that is Wn, and the change in volume, that is V4 minus V2, is the change in volume. Okay, V4 minus V2. So the mean effective pressure is becomes 0.2625 bar. The heat input, that is Q, that is Cp into T3 minus T2. Cp into T3 minus T2. So that becomes 1630.84 kilojoule per kg. Now the efficiency, so the efficiency becomes net work done by Q. So that is 7.23%. This is very low, okay, since the pressure ratio is quite small. Okay, the pressure ratio is quite small. In spite of the higher peak temperature, the efficiency is very low. This is the example that define that the efficiency of a simple cycle depends mainly on the temperature ratio and not on the peak temperature. Okay, that means the efficiency of a simple cycle depends on the pressure ratio, not on the peak temperature. In this numerical, it says that in a gas turbine, the pressure ratio to which air at 15 degrees Celsius is compressed is 6. The same air is then heated to a maximum permissible temperature of 750 degrees Celsius. First in a heat exchanger and then combustion chamber. It is then expanded in a two-stage such that the expansion work is maximum. The air is reheated to 750 degrees Celsius after the first stage. Find the cycle thermal efficiency and work ratio and the net shaft work per air. Okay. So, as it is given that the pressure ratio is 6. The C value, we know that C equals to R to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, and R is the pressure ratio. So C becomes 6 to the power 0.286. Gamma value is 1.4, and the T2 is the this temperature. Okay, 1 to 2 is the compression process, adiabatic compression process. So the using the temperature and pressure relation, the adiabatic temperature and pressure relation, we get T2 equals to T1 into C, this value. Okay, so we get T2 value. Okay, so for maximum expansion work, that is P3 by P4, that is equals to P5 by P6. That means this P3 by P4 is equals to P5 by P6. This is the reheat process. Okay, so that becomes root over RC, or we can say root over 6. This is the pressure ratio is equals to 2.54. Okay, now the 3 to 4 process. So this is the adiabatic expansion process. Here the T4, the temperature at point the first turbine exit, this is T4, is T3 by P3 by P4 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So that becomes 1023 by 2.45 to the power 0.286. So the T4 value is 791.7 Kelvin, and as the pressure ratio is same, so we can simply say that the T6 and T4 value is same. T4 and T6 value is same. Okay, so the compression work is becomes Cp into T2 minus T1. Cp into T2 minus T1, and Cp value is 1.005 into T2 value is 480.67 minus, and T1 value is 288. So the compression work, the value of compression work is 193.63 kilojoule per kg of air, and the turbine work, so 1 to 2 is the compression work. Okay, 1 to 2, this is the compression work, and turbine work is 3 to 4 sorry and turbine work is 3 to 4 and 5 to 6. So Wt is equals to Cp into T3 minus T4 plus Cp into T5 minus T6. So by substituting all these values, since the value of T4 and T6 is same and 3 and 5 is same, so we can simply write down that 2 into Cp into T4 minus T3 minus T4, 2 into Cp into T3 minus T4. So that becomes 464.9 kilojoule per kg of air. Now the heat addition. Heat addition, this process is the heat addition, that is 7 to 3 and 4 to 5. These two are the heat addition process. So the value of Q is Cp into T3 minus T7 plus T5 minus T4. Okay. Because it is given that the 100% generation, so we can simply write Q equals to 2 into Cp into T3 minus T7. Okay. So Q value becomes 464.9 kilojoule per kg of air. Now the net work done. Net work done is turbine work minus compression work, compressor work. So that becomes, by substituting compressor work from the turbine work, we get 271.34 kilowatt. 271.34 kilowatt. So the efficiency, the cycle efficiency, eta equals to net work done by heat input. So that becomes 58.36%. Now the work ratio, that is net work done to turbine work. Net work done to turbine work is 271.34 by 464.9. So that becomes 0.5836. So this is the answer. Thank you. In the next video, we will learn some other kind of numerical, that is, which is related to intercooler reheat, intercooler and heat exchange cycle, related to this kind of cycle. Okay. Thank you.